Soon, pumpkin spice lattes will be the only way to know if fall has really started. Thanks, climate change. Just offload all the seasons to corporations. Ugh. Speaking of that, I love summer, brought to you by Shark Week. Hey there, leaf peepers. Trace here for DNews. Let me lay this on you. Cool weather, pumpkin patches, warm boots, colorful leaves, corn mazes, apple cider, hay rides. Get ready to lose all of these things. Wah, wah. Climate change might be taking away all of the things that we love about my favorite season. Fall leaves, cool weather, and pumpkins. Fall is the harvest season, when summer transitions into winter and the plants, animals, and insects get ready to bear down and survive the cold months of the year. It's an important transition period, but in a matter of decades, it's become a completely different season. The most visible reminder of the season's change is the beautiful fall foliage. According to a 2005 study in plant physiology, leaf degradation takes place over about 18 days. But as fall changes, so too do our trees. If you're a fan of fall color, climate change, not your friend. The leaves of some trees, beech, birch, and poplar, are always brightly colored, but the reds and yellows are hidden under that blanket of chlorophyll green all year. Dogwoods, red maples, and red oaks create anthocyanins, which give their leaves a bright red color. The additional sunlight from drier, warmer weather can cause leaves to die sooner and dull their colors. Cold snaps is what makes those reds and yellows pop. Even ignoring the fall foliage, the warmer fall of the future will cause trees' leaves to stay greener longer and then drop early, shortening how much time we can actually enjoy it. Plus, temperature shifts let more insects move north, attacking trees that may not have been exposed to them in the past. Over time, native trees will die out as the climate becomes inhospitable for them. Chances are seedlings will start to take root further and further north, moving these forests away from their previous homes and into hospitable, cooler climates. A study in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences found that this is actually already happening. Hardwood trees have moved 300 feet northward since 1962. But even if you don't care about leaves or trees or whatever, you probably like pumpkins. This large fruit is native to the warmer regions of the Americas, and they're a very visible indication of autumn. The problem is, even though they like warmth, too warm and they'll ripen before the first leaf turns. According to the Ontario Ministry of Agriculture, pumpkins grow best when it's 75 to 85 degrees. Once a pumpkin ripens, the outside hardens, it's ready to pick off the vine. But this year, it's been hot, as you probably know. The heat was on so high that the pumpkins ripened and needed to be harvested in mid-August. In fact, Oregon-based Rogue Ales planted early in the spring because of the warmth and harvested in the late summer, which meant their pumpkin beer was out super early. If this warming trend continues, pumpkins might become a summer treat, not a fall staple. But don't go losing your gourd. Fall's still gonna exist, just be completely different. It's gonna be warmer for longer, throwing plant cycles out of sync and shifting harvest schedules. According to the 2011 issue of Global Change Biology, we are already affecting this climate. What was once stable is now shifting. The growing season has extended itself 2 weeks since 1982, meaning warmer weather for longer periods and a warmer fall season with more extreme precipitation, sometimes dry, sometimes wet. Insects, flowers, animals, and organisms of all shape and size rely on the delicate timing of spring, summer, fall, and winter. When whole seasons change in a matter of just a few years, some species are going to adapt, while others just go extinct. In the end, thanks to climate change or global warming or whatever you want to call it, the fall we have today is not the autumn of our grandparents, and the fall of our grandchildren isn't even going to resemble the one that we got in our childhood. Sidebar, not that it matters for those latte lovers out there, but climate change is making coffee difficult to grow too, so instead of the symbol of fall being a, you know, pumpkin thingy, it'll be a fake pumpkin thingy with whipped topping in a plastic cup with no coffee. Honestly, some people might not actually notice the difference. What's your favorite season? If it's fall, how do these changes make you feel? Also, I know you probably are already, but battle it out. Autumn or fall, which is better? If you want to argue with me about it and you live in San Francisco in the Bay Area, come to the DNews live show on October 22nd. Tickets are available now. They are going fast. We've got some friends of the show coming to talk to you all. Some space history, some illusions, some bioluminescence, animal sex, and even the science of creepy sounds. Grab a ticket with the link down in the description and watch our Twitter and Facebook pages for updates. October 22nd, San Francisco. It's going to be awesome. If you'd rather watch a video and you can learn all about the science of the pumpkin spice latte and why we love it so much, check that out here.
It's a beverage that captures the essence of fall, he says. But that doesn't explain why it still outperforms all the other seasonal beverages at Starbucks. Their eggnog and peppermint mocha lattes both predate pumpkin spice, but they just haven't caught on in the same way.
Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Please subscribe, and we'll see you tomorrow.